Now, this brings us to the next part of the day. We have two wonderful case studies to present. Our first case study will be a presentation on Jaipur and the revival of the arts and the various successful initiatives in the region that drive more patronage and support for the arts by the very esteemed author, publisher, and member of the Chief Minister's Advisory Committee of Rajasthan, Malvika Singh. Ms. Singh is joining us here from Delhi today, and besides being a respected publisher and author that I already mentioned, she's part of various private and public initiatives, cultural bodies, including the Ministry of Culture, Ranthambore Foundation, Rewa Society, UNESCO, Intact, and many more. She's a member of the advisory board of the Chief Minister's Office of Rajasthan, one more line, and is decorated, this I have to pronounce properly, and was decorated as the Dame in the Civil Merit Honours list of the King of Spain in 2009. For her complete, even more esteemed bio, refer to the handouts that you all have, and over to you, Ma.
4 years ago, in June, the Chief Minister of Rajasthan, who'd been in office since December the previous year, constituted an advisory committee. And we went to the first meeting and everyone looked at all of us and thought, oh God, here come this band of people who are disconnected with everything they're going to advise us on. And I could see those looks and I thought, now, what does one do? Does one attend two meetings a year and forget about it, get a TA and a DA and forget about it? Or should we really fix them by just delivering on the ground with a bunch of people? Her mandate to the Arts Committee, a little subcommittee of her Chief Minister's advisory, was that I'd like you guys to bring... First, she said to me, I want you to be a catalyst. I want you to bring people to the table who are under 45 years old. I'm about to be 70. And she said, I have no money to give you, but I want you to make Rajasthan into a public art gallery. Just deliver it. So I went home and I thought, where does one begin? And so we just began. She began the initiative, and I'm going to show you pictures, and I will speak over them. And Sanjoy is sitting here to prompt me, because beginnings of Alzheimer's, I might forget something. And he's here to prompt me. Okay, so we started with an ad campaign based on Jaane Kya Dikh Jaye. And it was a cutting edge young, we got rid of all the ideas of the Maharaja and the palace and land of the Rajas. And we said, young, new, different. Chief Minister said, why don't we get the Jogi artists who were discovered by Hakusha, in fact, who said to this itinerant group, can you draw? And they said, yes, we can draw. And the Jogi artists just decorated our bus stops. Next, just keep going. And the three-wheelers. And then she said public art. So these are local Rajasthan artists who use the gardens. Stop. Then Valmik Thapar said to me one day, why don't I get permission from the central government to get local artists to paint the walls of the railway stations? So he did Savai Madhopur. This happens to be Bharatpur. Now, it may not be in order, but here it is. This is the Bharatpur railway station. Now, you can just keep running the slides, please, for me. This is a young man painting, so the kala is still in the hands. Here's the station, a work in progress. This is, again, Jogi art at Jaipur Main. That's, again, Jogi art at Jaipur Main. This is Ranthambore, and that's it. Urinal, huh? And that's Ranthambore, carry on. This is the ceiling of Udaipur railway station and Nathdwara images, all done by local painters, all done under 15 lakhs of rupees. Some were more elaborate. This is Bapuji Kapar in Jodhpur. That's the ceiling. I'm just going to, all right, so now you just, so, just let's go through with the pictures and then I'll tell you. That's Jodhpur. Now look how clean the floor is looking. So Swachh Bharat and the two glasses. You give people something that looks beautiful and they're not going to spoil it. And it's got nothing to do with us and them and, you know, we can keep it clean and they can't. You have to make your public spaces clean. You have to make them friendly. And that is a picture taken by somebody on a phone, it's perfectly clean. Next. That is Kota. Now, all I said, you can stop here. All I said to the painter was, please go to the genre of Kota paintings, go to the museum, look at the paintings, and you reproduce them on the walls of the station. And that's a man painting, as you can see. Next. These are two young boys who were given the Udaipur station to do. And this is the most, this and Bikaner are the two most elaborate stations. This is a pillar, next. Another pillar, carry on. Ceiling. Now the ceiling is a shield, and they've just blown it larger than life. Cartouches. So here, if you stop the cartouches, they said we'll put, you know, Kabir Dohas, and we'll put something from, you know, religious texts. And then the collector said to me, but ma'am, then somebody will come and vandalize if it's not this religion and it's that religion. So rather than stop the project and get permission, we just decided to put animals and flowers. Nobody can object to that. Now, where did the money come from for all this? We decided to go to the collector's funds. And this was one way of getting rid of this whole business of the lowest common tender and taking 2 years and some huge cost, because there are all kinds of other rather unpleasant things kick in. So we just used local funds, and they paid. The only mandate, I'm sorry, the only mandate was don't bargain with the painters. Pay them whatever they want. If you don't have the money, we'll raise it from the corporate sector. We'll raise it from the private sector. We managed to raise all the money through the collectorates, and the collector supervised it, and the painter was given no brief. This is the designer. It is inside him, as Sangeeta was saying earlier in her presentation today, that it's there in everyone's bloodstream. Next. There are the cartouches with the flowers. And that's another ceiling. Those are the ceilings at a railway station in India. That was a Abha Narayan's architectural drawing, which we told them to blow up. And that's one of the walls in a Jaipur station. And that is the Bikaner station. Here, the painter was told, he rang me and said, kya karein udhar? So I said, wo jaake Badal Mahal dekh lijiye, udhar ek naksha hai, Badal ka. I said, any white space you have, paint it with that naksha, and that's the result. Next. And that he did on his own, you know, the arch and so on. Next. Okay. I was only the catalyst. I just kicked ass, as they say. That's all. Reinvention of heritage sites. Next. Huh? Please. Is there? Okay. All right. Now, reinvention. This is the reuse and reinvention of heritage sites. This is Albert Hall. So we decided to use it as a space for performances. So here's a Qawwali. Next. No, there should have been more pictures, but never mind. A museum shops. We never have this, we don't have this thing of museum shops. So we started next. So this is Amir Fort. We gave it out to CMYK, who created products that fit in with the site. And that's the museum shop at Amir now, and at Albert Hall, and then Jantar Mantar. Now the Kavar. This is a traditional, can you have the slide? This is a traditional storytelling device and in the Chittorgarh area. Just a minute. And we decided to use this opening of a kavar and create a mobile souvenir shop. Next. So that's the mobile souvenir shop, where you can take it to Hawa Mahal and stick it up there, and it's got that site-related keychains, mugs, T-shirts, blah. Next. Nahargarh. Now, here, if you can just pause, this is a fort that overlooks, as you can see, the city of Jaipur. Saath Saath Arts, and Noelle is sitting here, who represents Nahargarh now, she's in charge of this, came to me one day and said, you know, all of you talk about, this is an American who is talking, he said, all of you talk about, you know, setting up, using these monuments, can you give me a fort? So I said, yes, actually I can. Why don't you go to Jaipur tomorrow? He said, tomorrow? I said, yes, tomorrow. So he goes to Jaipur, he sees this. There's a palace there where the walls are painted with florals. And he's Saat Arts has raised money in the private sector and created an international sculpture gallery that's having a conversation with the past, and it is the present. Can we? So that's the courtyard, and you'll see it transformed in a minute. That's Subodh Gupta, that's Bharti Kher. So you enter this, and then you go into all these palace rooms. Next. That is a young designer in Delhi who makes these finials. So that conversation is happening with the finials on the palace roof. Next. These are the inside rooms. This is an international artist. I unfortunately don't know all their names. Okay, next. Next. It was very difficult to get the art up there. Now here I want to say that money. When I went to the chief minister on this project, I said, can we use one of your forts for a sculpture gallery, an international sculpture gallery? She looked at me, raised one eyebrow, and she said, yes. So she comes to the opening 9 months later. Only 9 months. That's why I was being belligerent in the front row, saying, it can be done if you want to do it. She came in there, she dropped her speech, and she said, I have to admit, when Mala came to me and said, can I use a fort? I said, yes, because I thought it would never happen. Saat Arts raised well over a crore, and I won't say how much, through the corporate sector, and that's what we created. Next. And there's a wax gallery there. Now, this is a very funny sort of over-the-top wax museum. And we said, why not? Now, this is a sheesh mahal done today. That's the floor of a modern sheesh mahal. Next. There you go. Looks like a kaleidoscope, you know? So we said, why don't we make products that are kaleidoscopes that pick up these patterns? So people can, kids can buy them, and then there's a connect to the fort. Next. Next. Conservation projects. Now this you can race through while I speak, okay?
Mala, just again, if you want, talk to us about how did you overcome actually getting the government to give over the fort to a private, so how did the private-public partnership work?
Okay. So I think what the chief minister had said to me initially was, please use the public spaces in Rajasthan and infuse them with young contemporary ideas. And she told the archaeological survey, we had a very clear mandate that if you use Nahargarh, for instance, nobody can come and knock a nail in. So the archaeological survey had a blueprint, and they put in the lights based on what the requirement was. They knocked the nails in. The private practitioner did not do that. And I think what happened was actually, Sanjoy, is that I didn't just go there and say, do this. I sat there and talked to all these babus. Excuse the word, I'm not saying it badly, because it was a great partnership. I have to say that I have never, ever had an experience like that where maybe 0.1% of a bureaucrat was anti what we were doing. They all doubled up for us. And Sanjoy will tell you also, when there's been trouble on the streets during the Lit Fest, the bureaucrats have actually come up trumps, right? Wrong. Have to bring some of the laughs in, you know? So, and then he rings me and says, "Are yaar, you know, this is happening, right? Or wrong?" So anyway. So that's how it happened. And you know, there's no blueprint for it. It's human relations. I really do believe this initiation of all these projects was human relations. And we're going to end by telling you, at the end of the show, I thought I'd do it, but I'm doing it now because he's asked for it. We want to set up a commission called the Landmarks Commission as a working title, which has a different set of rules that apply, where the government representative is actually there as a landlord of the property. And what you do within the property lies in the purview of the creative practitioner, to use an, I mean, a word that, you know, covers all ground. We are in the process of making it into an act and hopefully put it through the Legislative Assembly in the monsoon session, which is next month. If that happens, it becomes a template for a lot of other states, if they want to follow it, where you work in partnership, but the landlord doesn't tell you how to do the interior, basically. And the funding is create a corpus where the government and a private corpus match each other, and then for every project you do, you can raise money without everyone interfering and saying, why are you raising money? Under what section are you raising this money? We're going to cut all that out. So it's in process, and let's hope it happens. Conservation projects. I just picked some to show you. In 4 years, we have done endless restoration projects, and just run through them, before and after. Deeg Fort, just carry on. Just to give you an idea, quick, fast. Okay, all right. I've only got so much time, you know, and it's a long presentation. Now, we'd like to use these places for music festivals. You know, they're all near airports, and they're all near railheads. We would love to use them. And so anyone with an idea, come. We'll facilitate you. Government facilitates, does not tell you how and what to do. You bring a proposal, a small governing council accepts your proposal or rejects it or asks you to modify it, and government facilitates you. Next, now there were 18 state museums in Rajasthan. The chief minister in 2 budgets allocated resource to restore the building, engineering, and put out tenders. So my role there was to persuade all these lovely young designers all over the place to go and fill a tender. Nobody wants to work with government. It's the truth, because it's so cumbersome. So I said, no, we will facilitate you to fill the tender. So they worked on it. And of course, I called in a lot of favors. Well, all these youngsters who've eaten in my home, I said, now come on, put your money where your mouth is. And this is what happened. This is Albert Hall. Albert Hall outside, restored by government, and this is how it looks. It's a very retro museum. Just go on. And now we have music and all that happening there in the evenings. Pali, small little town. That's the Pali Museum. And that's a beautiful Shiva. Bikaner station is better than the museum, but nevertheless, it's a beginning. Ajmer, this is a Mughal, it goes back, you know, to Akbar, actually.
It's where Akbar signed the East India Company Farman.
So that's what the museum looks like now. What's your name? Sanjoy. You can do something. Seeker. Seeker Museum. This is Seeker. Have you heard of Seeker, all of you? Oh, I see Cyrus there. Hi. Seeker Museum. Next. That's Seeker. Bharatpur. Now, Bharatpur, Abha Narayan Lamba did it. She's a Bombay girl. Look at what she's produced. And she should have been here to see her work. That's Bharatpur. Jodhpur Museum, just done. It's not Mehrangarh. It's now going to compete. Sardar Museum. There it is. Done by Siddharth Das. Jawahar Kala Kendra. Okay, stop. Now here was something. This was set up. Kendras and Lalit Kala Academies, etc., were set up in all the state capitals or in most of them in the 50s. State was going to support and rejuvenate the arts. They all fell asleep over time. Because everyone who was waiting for a posting was posted there, and they weren't interested, so the whole thing fell apart. Now, we have all these buildings. This is a building by Charles Courier. It's a fantastic building. It had fallen apart. Charles, just before he died, went to Jaipur, walked through the building, came back, rang me up and said, I'm just so depressed. So we talked to the chief minister. She restored the building back to what it was. And she said, revive it. She gives diktats of that kind. And then I said, how much money do you have to put into this? She said, nothing. Go raise it. People. So that's when I realized that when you take money from the state takes ownership. The composition of the state changes every 5 years. The diktat, the political diktat. So the bureaucrat has to do on the bidding of the new boss. Everything falls apart. We have to separate heritage and legacy from being funded by the state. But because the state owns the buildings in which that heritage rests, they are the landlord. Therefore, a new commission. So let's go through this. This is a Charles Currier building. He got all these frescoes done. Carry on. Now, they've all been restored. We changed the auditorium. We cleaned it all up. Pooja Sood was invited. I have to tell you this story. So Bharti Kher, I rang up Bharti Kher. I said, Bharti, would you like to come to Jaipur and work on this art center? Make it an art center, contemporary art center. And she said, oh, not at all. Who wants to work with government? I only make art, she said. So I said, I would really like you to just come, meet the chief minister once, reject the idea if you don't want to do it. She came, met. She brought in Pooja Sood from Coach, and she said, turn it around. We gave her a governing council of people of her choice, outside of government, one or two government chaps. Pooja came in, she took all the old furniture, sold it to the kabadi, and raised many lakhs, and started the redoing of the interior. And that's next. It is the single most active art space in India, even if I say so myself. Next. That is a cafe where all the tables are the waning and waxing moon, done by Charles. So we restored it back, and it still has India Coffee House there. We opened another cafe upstairs called Quaint. So you have the two. Then, now, more expensive, less expensive, and so on. That's the space. It's active from 11 o'clock to 11 o'clock at night. There are an average of 500 to 1,000 people there every day. Next. So these are all the functions. I just put it together. Move it because they'll throw me off the stage in a minute. Done. Jaipur Literature Festival. We can race through this because we know all about it. Now, wait, 1 minute. Where do you get audiences like this? I'm willing to challenge anybody. Today, in Rajasthan, you get audiences like this everywhere. And I'll show you slides as we go on. Sanjoy, I mean, I have to say this, even grudgingly, was the initiator of changing the mindset in Jaipur. Because I walked into a session at the Jaipur Lit Fest, and sitting next to me was my driver. I said, aap kya kar rahe hain? He said, jo aap kar rahe hain. Next. And then I said to, stop. I said to Sanjay, now come on, can you quickly put together sacred Pushkar? He said, what do you mean? I said, just take November, Kartik Purnima, and start a sacred music festival. Those are the people I pulled in. If I hadn't had the Sanjoys and the Seher and the X and the Y and all these good friends of mine who came and rescued me and created these new properties, I wouldn't be here today. Happy? Sacred music. This is a music festival that is done on the Pushkar Lake, never been allowed before by the Pandas. Now the Pandas are begging to be there, for them to be there. Next. They do historic walks through the city, they do yoga, they have the great drummers, they have flautists. Next. And then they top it all with some rap. That was the first one. I just want to just show, these are just pictures from the telephone. Udaipur world music. So then I got hold of Seher and I said, I want world music in Udaipur. And you have to go and raise the money. He raised the money from the private sector, as did Sanjoy. Although I know it was a little difficult, and it still is, but we will carry on doing it. And That's Udaipur World Music. Tasneem's brother-in-law came to me and said, but thank you so much. Because it's... So that's on the bank of the Pichola Lake. Morning sessions, carry on. Aruna Sairam. And that is in the evening in the football stadium. That is the number of people who come. All free entry. Because the mandate was, open it up to the people. I want no ticketing. So that's it. Next. 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 From Ivory Coast, from Cuba, from all over the world, 18 rock bands arrive. That's the afternoon session on another lake. So it's rocking. I basically want to tell you it's cool and it's rocking. Next. Next. So then we said travel photo Jaipur. I was in Goa, I met Nikhil Padgaunkar, I saw some show he'd done. I said, why don't you come to Jaipur? He said, okay, he comes to Jaipur, he gets, it's called, what is it called? Travel photo Jaipur, Wanderlust. He gets photographers from across the world, blows up their stuff and uses buildings. Next. There. That's how it is all across the city. That's the Hawa Mahal. And that's the audience. Then we said we've got khadi clusters in Rajasthan. They were all dying a natural death. Next. We started Handmade in Rajasthan, where we got international designers in India and abroad to buy a minimum of 500 meters of Rajasthan khadi and create special collections, which are then showcased in fashion shows for 5 days in Diggy Palace. We took it to London. We had a great response for people buying our khadi. Next. Next. And this is the Heritage Week, fashion shows and craft and skill. We call in, keep showing. We call in, I hope you're proud of our names. We call in all the shilp gurus, master craftsmen, and give them free space to show their wares and sell them and make contact with buyers. Craft Pavilion, carry on. State Archives, next picture. So this archive was built by Ganga Singh in the year dot as State Archives. There's now the State Archives of Rajasthan. That's what it looks like. That's Dayanita Singh's camera. She said to me one day, I really like to photograph files. You know, I'm doing a project on files. So I said, go to Rajasthan. You'll see all the files, every government office. And she put her camera down and said, make this a museum. And it's going to be a museum opening on October 1. We're putting glass so that people can walk through and see the National Archive. Next, film archive. So she stumbled upon, again, Dayanita, stumbled upon this in Ajmer. 5,000 films ranging from Bicycle Thieves to the shorts we used to see when we were kids, my generation, before a feature film in a cinema theater. And this is going to be now a viewing theater, a new building has been allocated, everything's going to be digitized, blah. Next. Next. And that's the poor man who spent 10 years doing this to make sure that everything is okay inside the tin box. So he's been given a Raj Puruskar. Next. Now, next. This is an art school that was set up in 1800 and something by the Brits, by Henley. And it had fallen apart inside. Next shot. Next. This is Jaipur. Sorry, this is in Kishanpur, Jaipur. Next. Smart City entered, took the property and restored it just to what it was. Just roll these shots. That's the space. Okay, stop. So she said, do something with this. So I said, how much money do you have? She said, nothing. So I said, okay, then what should we do? Because for a museum, you need money. You need to be able to buy art, you need to be able to display art, you need to be able to look after that art. So I, at that point, said, okay, we'll make a museum of legacies. So they said to me, what is that? So I said, it's never been done, let's do it. So we give away these halls free of charge for the first year, and people who are collectors can bring their collections and showcase them in this museum for a year, 2 years, or 3 years, and we have a loan agreement with them. So this was the opening night. Next. So I had to fill one of the halls, so I just made two very large puppets and hung them there. That's the entrance now. Next. That's the courtyard, and that's where I would like Kruti to take on a project and use this space to do what she was doing here in Dharavi, do it in the old city of Jaipur. So I'm inviting you to come and do it if you're in the audience. Next. That kind of work is done today in Rajasthan, that kind of carving. And that is Mitch Kreitz's gallery. And I'm just showing you a piece from there. Next. These are all private collections. Next. That's a Pichwai gallery, Pooja Singhal. Poor thing, I just rang her up. I said, we have to fill that gallery. You've got exactly 6 days. And she delivered it. So there it is. Central Jail for Women. Now, next. So this is, please look at the floor. How beautiful is that terrazzo? That's a jail. So I said that if I'm ever arrested, please see that I'm transferred there. So what happened there was I just said, I'd like to see the jail. Because I happen to know the head of jails who was a SP in Sawai Madhopur 20 years ago. So I went to the jail and that's what I saw. Next. They're making spices. Next. And by the way, the white sari women are murderers. So I said, how are you a murderer? So she said, well, my husband beat me, my mother-in-law would beat me, and one day I pushed my husband and cracked his skull. And I'm here and I never want to go back. Making rajais. Kresh, please look at the floor. See how clean. Then they didn't know I was coming. Next. That is the cell. Fans, please notice. So I said, jail shop, Hojai. So that's the jail shop. I said, what would you like to call the jail shop? And they said, Ashai, which means hope. And there it is. I was given a garage, so I quickly got them to paint some funny clouds there and open that. And they make this furniture in the men's jail. They make the Navar. Everything is made by them. The vegetables are grown organically in the jail gardens. We just started a whole thing. Next. And the walls are all painted by murderers. Next. In fact, this dari maker, I just said to him, I said, aapke haath mein bahut kala hai. And he fell at my feet and said, 7 logon ka qatl kiya hai, madam. Next. That's the man who said that to me. He's gorgeous looking. Look at him. Next. And that's the shop. So the shop had bathroom tiles, white and grey walls. I said, what's your budget? So they said, madam, you'll have to go for tender. So I said, no, what do you have that you can give me right away? They said, 18,000 rupees. So I said, go get that red paint. Paint the ceiling, the floor, and the walls red. And the bathroom tiles, which were white, paint them black. And stick all your products in there. And that's the shop. 18,000 rupees flat. No designer. Next. Those are the daris. Daris made in the central men's jail. Next. Bikaner House. So Bikaner House, next. Iconic bungalow. It was the bus adda for everyone going from Delhi to Mayo and Jaipur and blah and blue. She restored it. Stop. She restored it and said to me, same thing. Do something. I said, what do you want to do with the building? I want to return Bikaner House to the people of Delhi. And I want you to make it something. So I said, okay, we just make it a upgraded India International Center. Right? So that's how we started. No money. So I got Vivek Sani of Karma. I said, I don't care what you say to me. You will go fill the tender and take that shop and pay me the rent. So he did. That's the shop. It has rooms on both sides. Next. Chor Bazaar. I rang up Rohit Khattar. I said, you owe me big time. Fill in the tender. I went to every single top-notch design restaurant. A.D. Singh, Ritu, whatever, Italian, all of them. They said, no, what will be the footfalls there? Nobody will come. How can we do it? And government. So I said, okay, fine. 2.5 years later, A.D. sent me an SMS saying, I really regret that conversation with you because today this is the only hub in Delhi. Next. Exhibitions. Now just go through. So Bikaner House generates money, and in the first 18 months, we generated 1.5 crore, which all went back into the consolidated fund of Rajasthan. We didn't have any money to buy a bulb. So that has to be restored and restructured so that it becomes autonomous. and the money generated remains with it to do more exhibitions and so on. And so carry on, this is the outside. So we have shows, exhibitions, music recitals in the garden. Every day something's happening, and I'd like to say it's booked till April next year. Next. Sit-down dinners. This is Gudda, not us. I mean, this is Rohit Bal. Huh? Les gens d'honneur events. Next. Film festivals, next. Keep going. Exhibitions, fashion exhibitions, a fabulous exhibition. Merchandise, Sunday bazaar. I said, you know, all now here again, cities, public spaces. Somebody arrives in government and says, you know, these flower sellers that are at every corner and in every locality of Delhi, send them out to the boundary of Delhi. Are? So they've gone out. So I said, bring them all back to Bikaner House. So there they are. Next. So their sabzis are sold here. People who are growing in their backyard come and sell. Somebody's making nice lassi, honey, God knows what. They have a free space on Sundays at Bikaner House to bring their wares. They have to set them in a certain manner that we, they just can't come and just set up. We give them we orchestrate the whole scenario for them and the scene, and that's Bikaner House. So everyone comes and buys their stuff at mandi prices. Not mall prices. Next. Future plans. So one part of Bikaner House was, you can keep rolling this. One part of Bikaner House was assigned to RAW, you know, research analysis wing. We got the building back, so we're creating five more galleries there, a retail space, a first floor to Bikaner House where we're going to have a jazz bar, and we're going to have a mini theater for films with proper acoustics and so on. And we are going to have a retail outlet, I told you, and a pottery workshop. Impact. Now, the inner city of Jaipur is being lit. And five inner cities are being floodlit across Rajasthan. Switches will come on the 15th of August. And go on. And that's what it'll look like in the evening, at sunset to midnight. Next. All done by Abha Narayan Lamba, who again I pulled into Rajasthan, and she groaned and grumbled, and I made her do a lot of things free without a fee. Masala chalk. So next. Okay, stop. Now, people in Jaipur don't go out and eat. They all eat at home. They have their little, you know, everybody is very careful about what they eat and jhuta and this and that. Very conservative. We had an idea to do this. The structure was built and we didn't know what to do. So on the 10th of January this year, Chief Minister said, we should open this masala chowk idea of yours by the 26th. 6th. We open it on Republic Day. 4th, okay. And Meeta Kapoor, who's a literary agent but loves her food, I rang her up and I said, you just take ownership of this and do it, deliver. No, but you know, how will we do it? And then, you know, the JDA, Jaipur Development Authority, blah, blue, grown grant. She's working with government. She opened it and there's 1,000 people there, summer, winter. It has not made a difference. People come and eat. Next to it is an amphitheater and a garden, next shot. And we give this out every evening. We don't charge more than 2,000 rupees. Anyone can take it. Poetry readings, music, local rock groups. Next. Tapri, a bunch of youngsters started this. This is a breakfast place and it goes through the day. Next. These are all private initiatives. Palladio Cafe, just show the pictures. Next. I don't know why this slide keeps coming up, but never mind, my fault. Amrapali Museum of Jewelry. This is a museum that is the single most fabulous museum of jewelry in India today. Next. All done by the private people who live there, who feel now that Jaipur's got a buzz. Jaipur's cool. Jaipur has these festivals. Jaipur is, we can now risk starting something because we'll get the footfalls. Anoki Textile Museum, I'm just showing you what's happening in the city. Next. City Museum Gallery. Next. Go, just show. I just want pretty pictures. Go on. Jaipur Fort Museum. Rapid. I'm not handling it. This is a library that's been restored. Keep going. Taking ownership. Jaane kya dikh jaye. Thank you.
You know, the reason why I was very keen for Mala to come and do this legacy document, and this is something that she's been working on for a while, is because I wanted everybody here, state governments, to understand that it is possible. We just have to work out of the box. We have to work in partnership. We have to work as collectives. Government is not necessarily the bad guys on the block. They too can facilitate and make things happen. We have to just work with them in a particular way in a public-private partnership scheme. And today, for the lack of a better word, Rajasthan is in many ways become iconic for, it's always been iconic for heritage and culture, but it's really become the arts central for India. And there's no reason, in the same way that you've seen, whether it's in Maharashtra or any other part of India today, there are hundreds of buildings, museums, private homes, collections, all of which can bring footfalls, tourists, our association with heritage, and it's absolutely important for us to be able to engage with this and not see culture and art and heritage anymore as only for people like us in this room, but for everybody. You want to bring about change, we have to open it up, we have to allow everybody access to it. Thank you.
That I have got more flack for doing what I've done than applause. I want to say that everyone I know in my city says, "Are yaar, she was able to do it because she had the ear of the chief minister." I neither had a ear, I had access, like all her bureaucrats have access, but I had access to the bureaucrats. And let me say that they did it. And if bureaucrats feel, let me tell you, if you have the ear of the chief minister, bureaucrats want to dig you in the back and smile in front of you. That did not happen. Without them, none of this would have happened. And I want to salute the government of Rajasthan. And I don't say this because I can't stand working with government till this experience happened.